Myself, I am Gunakar, Assistant Professor of Zoology, Government Degree College, Siddipet. Today, let us discuss rabbit digestive system. Rabbit belongs to phylum Chordata, subphylum Vertebrata, superclass Gnathostomata, division Tetrapoda, class Mammalia, subclass Theria, infraclass Eutheria, order Lagomorpha, family Leporidae, genus Oryctolagus, species Cuniculus. Its common name is the European grey rabbit. Is almost cosmopolitan or worldwide in distribution, but its original home had been Western Europe and Africa, from where it was carried to various parts of the world, including India, by man. As far as the digestive system of rabbit is concerned, the digestive system includes the organs concerned with mastication, swallowing, digestion of food, and elimination of undigested matter. It consists of two parts, elementary canal and digestive glands. Elementary canal is formed by many organs, starting with mouth and ending with anus. Mouth is followed by vestibule, buccal cavity, pharynx, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, and anus. Mouth is a relatively small transverse aperture present at the tip of the snout. It is bordered by two soft, fleshy and movable lips. The large upper lip is divided by a median vertical cleft running up to the nostrils, whereas the lower lip is not divided. Because of this cleft, the large and sharp upper incisors are exposed externally even when the mouth is closed. This arrangement enables the rabbit to bite effectively. Mouth leads to the vestibule. Vestibule is a narrow vertical slit-like space, is bounded externally by the lips and cheeks and internally by the gums of jaws. Mucus glands are found in its lining. Then vestibule leads behind into oral cavity or buccal cavity. It is lined with mucous membrane and contains palate, tongue and teeth. The palate is the roof of the oral cavity, whose anterior part is called hard palate and posterior part is called soft palate. The palate divides the original buccal cavity into a nasal passage above and a foot passage below. Lower surface of the hard palate bears transverse ridges called palatal rugae. The hard palate is extended back as the flexible, smooth and fleshy soft palate. The posterior end of the soft palate hangs down freely into pharynx as a small flap called uvula. Near its anterior end, the hard palate is perforated by a pair of small openings of nasopalatine ducts or canals leading into nozzle or olfactory chambers. Each canal lodges a sensory Jacobson's organ. The function of Jacobson's organ is to recognize different types of food. Now coming to the tongue. Most of the floor of the buccal cavity is occupied with this tongue. The tongue remains largely attached to buccal cavity's floor. Dorsal surface bears numerous papillae which contain taste buds. There are four types of papillae: fungiform papillae, filiform papillae, circumvallate papillae, and foliate papillae. Now come to the teeth. The teeth of rabbit are present on both the jaws. Teeth are thecodont. They are firm. That means they are firmly embedded in the cup-like sockets of the jaw bones. The teeth of rabbit are also described as diphyodont. That is, only two sets are present throughout life. The first set is known as deciduous or milk dentition. It is lost in youth and replaced in the adult by the permanent dentition, which cannot be replaced. Teeth are also described as heterodont teeth, that is, they are of different types: incisors, canines, premolars and molars. Of course, the canines are completely absent in the rabbit, so its dental formula of rabbit is 2033/1023. That means each half of upper jaw has two incisors, no canines, three premolars and 3 molars. Whereas lower jaw, that is dentary bone, bears 1 incisor, no canines, 2 premolars and 3 molars. Hence, its dental formula is 2033 by 1023. The gap left due to the absence of canines is called the diastema. Premolars and molars are called cheek teeth or grinders, helps in grinding food. Buccal cavity behind leads into a narrow chamber, the pharynx. The pharynx incompletely divided into three parts: nasopharynx, oropharynx and laryngopharynx. The laryngopharynx leads posteriorly into the esophagus through a wide aperture, the gullet, into the esophagus. The esophagus is a long, narrow, elastic and muscular tube. It runs straight down through the neck and dorsal and parallel to the trachea. After piercing the diaphragm, it enters the abdomen and joins the stomach through its inner concave side. Stomach is the broadest part of the alimentary canal. It is situated on the left side in the anterior part of the abdominal cavity. The bean-shaped stomach has a smaller inner concave surface and larger outer convex surface, known as the lesser and greater curvatures respectively. The larger anterior part of stomach is known as the cardiac stomach and the smaller posterior part as the pyloric stomach. In between these two, there is a small short fundic stomach is also present. The stomach performs three main functions. Number one, storage of food. Number two, mechanical churning of food. And number three, partial digestion of the food. Then small intestine. The small intestine following stomach is a long, narrow and much convoluted tube. This is the intestine up to here. It is made of three parts: duodenum, jejunum and ileum. Duodenum is the smallest first part following the pyloric end of the stomach. It forms the typical U-shaped loop containing the pancreas. A bile duct opens into the beginning of its proximal limb, while a pancreatic duct opens into the beginning of the distal limb. The wall of the duodenum contains intestinal glands, that is crypts of Lieberkuhn, which are characteristic branchial, and also the branched Brunner's glands. Then behind the duodenum is jejunum, followed by ileum. There is no clear morphological distinction between the two, but they are histologically differentiated. Both are more than 2 meters long. The distal end of the ileum is expanded to form a small spherical sac, which is called sacculus rotundus. It opens into the cecum through an ileocecal valve. Digestion is completed and its end products absorbed in the small intestine. At the junction of ileum and colon, a wide, about 50 centimeter long, thin-walled tube is present, which is called the cecum. It is once recognizable due to its peculiar external spiral constriction, which makes the presence of an internal spiral valve. Distally, cecum terminates in a small, thick-walled, about 15 centimeter long, narrow, blind tube, the vermiform appendix. Cellulose of plant material is broken by bacterial action inside the cecum. Large intestine, it contains 1 meter long and consists of two regions, colon and rectum. Near the sacculus, ileum is continued into colon, which is wide, about 45 centimeters long and regularly sacculated or constricted wall. Now the rectum. It is the narrow terminal part, about 75 centimeters long. Fecal pellets present inside give it a beaded appearance. Anus. Rectum opens to the outside through anus, which is situated at the base of the tail. It is guarded by an anal sphincter. This total large intestine serves to absorb water from food and helps in the formation and elimination of fecal pellets. Coming to the digestive glands. Digestive glands are of following types, many types: mucus glands, salivary glands, gastric glands, liver, pancreas and intestinal glands. Mucus glands. These occur throughout the mucus lining of the digestive tract. They are mainly found in the lining of the vestibule. The secret, a viscous, slimy secretion called mucus. It contains mucin, which is a mixture of some proteins. Mucus helps in the moistening, lubrication, and swallowing of food in the buccal cavity. It also coats the mucus lining throughout the alimentary canal and protects it from the action of enzymes. Salivary glands. Four pairs of salivary glands open by their ducts separately into buccal cavity. They are named according to their position. Parotid glands are situated at the base of external ears or pinna. Their duct open behind the upper incisors. Infraorbital glands, they open near the upper molars. The submandibular glands are submaxillary glands. Their ducts open just behind the lower incisors. Then sublingual glands, they open below the free part of the tongue. The secretion of salivary glands is an alkaline watery liquid called saliva, which mixes with the food masses in the buccal cavity. The main function of the saliva is to provide a lubrication to make swallowing easier. It also contains an enzyme called ptyalin, which converts starch into maltose. Gastric glands are found in the mucous membrane of the stomach. They are microscopic, simple or branched. Their secretion is called gastric juice, which mixes with the food in the stomach. Besides mucus, it contains proenzymes called pepsinogen, renin and hydrochloric acid. Liver is the largest gland in the body, attached to the posterior concavity of diaphragm by a fold of peritoneum called falciparum ligament. Liver is purely divided into five lobes. Three lobes on the left side are small: spigelian lobe, left lateral lobe and left central. Two lobes on the right side are caudate lobe and right central. A dark green thin-walled gallbladder is also present. Liver cells secrete a greenish fluid called the bile. A hepatic duct arises from each liver lobe. These unite with the cystic duct from the gallbladder to form a common bile duct. The liver secretion, that is bile juice, is secreted into the proximal arm of duodenum near pylorus or pyloric sphincter. Its opening is guarded by a sphincter. Bile is an alkaline and mainly serves to emulsify fats in the duodenum. Next, pancreas. The pancreas is a regularly branched pinkish gland held in the mesentery in the U-shaped duodenal loop. It's a single duct opens into the distal limb of duodenum. The histological structure of pancreas is fundamentally similar in all vertebrates. The cells of pancreatic acini secrete an alkaline pancreatic juice. It contains several enzymes such as pepsinogen, amylase, lipase, which act on proteins, starches and fats respectively. Physiology of digestion, which includes five processes. Number one, ingestion. Two, digestion. Three, absorption. Four, assimilation. And five, egestion. The rabbit is herbivorous animal. Its food mainly consists of green leaves, vegetables, grasses, cereals, roots and barks. The food is cut into smaller pieces by means of its sharp incisor teeth. It bites with the help of upper and lower incisors, and food pieces are taken into buccal cavity by the movable lips through mouth. Inside the buccal cavity, the premolars and molars grind or chew the fragments of food. Their flat surfaces are traversed by the enamel ridges and well adapted for mastication. Then the masticated food is manipulated by the tongue. Mucus and saliva are mixed to moisten and lubricate the food, which changes into a small ball of bolus. It is easily swallowed through esophagus into stomach. Bolus is pushed down the esophagus by a wave of muscular contraction called peristaltic movements. During swallowing, the epiglottis closes the glottis and the soft palate pushed upwards to prevent entry of food into larynx and nasal passage respectively. Digestion of food commences in the buccal cavity itself and continues into the stomach, and it is completed in the intestine. In the buccal cavity, the food mixes with saliva secreted by the salivary glands. It contains the enzyme ptyalin, which converts starch to maltose. The pH of saliva is close to about 6 to 7, that is neutral, which is suitable for the action of ptyalin. Action of gastric juice on the food is occurs in the stomach. The muscular wall of stomach undergoes contractions. As a result, the food is churned, broken into smaller bits and thoroughly mixed with the gastric juice secreted by the gastric glands. The gastric juice contains mucus, hydrochloric acid and the enzymes renin and pepsin. Hydrochloric acid kills bacteria of the food, stops the action of ptyalin, which cannot work in the acidic medium. It activates the proenzyme pepsinogen into pepsin also. The hydrochloric acid also provides an acidic medium for pepsin to work. It stops contractions of the stomach. Then the enzyme renin coagulates soluble milk protein caseinogen. The pepsin partially breaks down proteins into simpler peptones. The semi-digested food in the stomach is called chyme. In the beginning of gastric digestion, the pyloric sphincter is closed. After some time, the pyloric sphincter opens from time to time so that the little by little the chyme is forced into duodenum by the peristaltic contractions of the stomach wall. Once in the duodenum, the chyme mixes with the three digestive juices, bile, pancreatic juice and intestinal juice. The bile is secreted by the liver, which has no enzymes, but it emulsifies the fats, that is splitting of larger fat molecules into smaller ones for more effective digestion. Then pancreatic juice is strongly alkaline, whose pH is about 8.8, and like bile, it neutralizes acidity of chyme. Its enzymes like steatopsin hydrolyzes fats to fatty acids and glycerol. Amylase, which is present in the pancreatic juice, it converts starch into maltose. Trypsinogen, a proenzyme which is activated by intestinal enterokinase into the proteolytic trypsin, that converts peptones into amino acids. Now come to the intestinal juice. Intestinal juice has many enzymes such as enterokinase, which activates trypsinogen into trypsin, erepsin, which converts peptones to amino acids, maltase, which changes maltose to glucose, invertase, which changes sucrose to glucose and fructose, lactase, which changes milk sugar or lactose to glucose and galactose. Now come to the digestion of cellulose. A large part of food of rabbit consists of cellulose. Digestion of cellulose occurs in the cecum, which is specially well developed in rabbit and all herbivorous mammals. It is inhabited by a vast number of symbiotic bacteria and protozoa. These break up cellulose into soluble sugar and in return get nitrogenous food from habit. These bacteria furnish a good example of symbiotic relationship between plant and animal. As a result of intestinal digestion, the chyme is converted into an alkaline watery emulsion, the chyle, which is absorbed into the lymphatic system through lacteals. The sugars, amino acids, water, minerals and vitamins are absorbed from the gut into the capillaries of villi and taken to liver by the hepatic portal vein. A lymph vessel called lacteal is also present within each villus. Glycerol and fatty acids pass from the gut into the lacteal and carried into the blood system via the lymphatic system. After absorption in the ileum, the remaining food which is undigested reaches the large intestine. It includes water and solid indigestible remains of the food and includes water and solid indigestible remains such as vegetable fibers and cellulose, for the digestion of which there are no appropriate enzymes. The feces form small dehydrated pellets which are periodically eliminated through the anus. This is known as egestion or defecation. What is the specialty of rabbit is coprophagy. The rabbits are described as coprophagous, which is a habit of eating its own feces in order to get maximum amount of nutrition from its food. Feces produced during night alone are eaten up, which are soft and moist due to incompletely digested cellulose. Thus, passing through the gut Once more, the feces are subjected once again to digestion and absorption. Feces produced during daytime, which are dry and hard, are not at all eaten. Thank you.